Today we are going to study the kinetics of the fluid particle reaction where chemical reaction resistance is dominant.
Consider a gaseous reactant A which is reacting with B. We are already familiar with this reaction. A in gaseous phase plus B times B in solid phase giving product, and we are also familiar with this diagram. But here with respect to the previous video where the gas film is dominant, with respect to that video, here what is the difference? Here gas film is not providing any resistance. Also ash layer is not providing any resistance. So whatever concentration of A which is outside the particle will be coming as it is inside the particle, and it is also transmitting as it is over the surface of core. That is described in this diagram. And as soon as your reactant A comes over the surface, it will be consumed. So rate of mass transfer will be equal to rate of chemical reaction. So in this way, it will be minus 1 upon 4 pi RC square dNA by dT, which will be K double dash into CAG, where K double dash will be the rate constant of that reaction, and reaction will be depend upon the concentration of A in gaseous phase, CAG. Now here we are considering the surface of that unreacted core. That is why rate will be in terms of 4 pi RC square, that is on the basis of the exposed surface of the unreacted core. Now you are already knowing from the stoichiometry we can write minus dNA by dt, that will be minus 1 upon B dNB by dt. So we can substitute minus dNA by dt by 1 minus 1 by B dNB by dt. So our expression will be minus 1 upon 4 pi R square 1 by B dNB by dt, which is K double dash into CAG. So NB is rho B into V. V will be replaced by 4 by 3 pi RC cube. Now it will be differentiated to calculate dNB by dt. So dNB by dt will be 4 pi rho B into R square dCr upon dt. That will be due to differentiation of RC cube with 3. So it will be 3 RC square dRC by dt. So it will cancel out 3. So we have got the equation number 4 that we will substitute in the equation number 3. So our equation will become minus 1 upon 4 pi r square into 1 by b 4 pi rho b r square rc square drc by dt, which is k double dash into CAG. That is a modification in 3 when you substitute equation 4 in 3. So it cancel out 4 pi r square 4 pi r square, and thus you get minus rho b upon b drc upon dt, which is k double dash into CAG. Now by variable separable method you can separate out the rc and time, and thus after integration you get minus rho b upon b k double dash CAG, which is r to rc integration drc, which is equal to 0 to t dt. So after integration we get minus rho b upon b k double dash CAG with into rc within the limit r to rc, which is equal to t. Now you can substitute the limits, so it will be rc minus r. Then you can absorb the negative sign and take R common. So it will be rho b into R in bracket 1 minus RC upon R divided by B k double dash into CAG, which is equal to T. Now this will be your expression for time. Means we can calculate the time for change of the particle size from R to RC using this expression. Now we can replace T by tau, RC by 0. And thus we get the total time of reaction for our case. So tau will be rho b into r upon b k double dash into CAG, because this bracket will come 1 after substituting rc is equal to 0. So what we conclude from this, tau directly proportional to r for this situation also, where the chemical reaction is dominant resistance. Now you can divide 5 by 6, so it will be T by tau, which is 1 minus RC upon R. All common things will cancel out. So this will be our equation number 7. Now we already know from our previous video that 1 minus XB, that is the fraction of B unreacted, is nothing but volume of the core divided by total volume of the solid. And from this you get this expression, XB is equal to 1 minus RC upon R bracket cube. So it gives 1 minus xb is equal to rc upon r bracket cube. That will be very much useful. And for this expression, you require rc upon r. So we can take out the cube root on both sides. So it will be rc upon r, which is 1 minus xb raised to 1 by 3. After substituting this 8 in 7, you will get t by tau is equal to 1 minus, in bracket, 1 minus xb raised to 1 by 3. Now this is the final expression that you want, that is relating t, tau and xb for our case of chemical reaction as dominant resistance. Thank you.